Okie dokie. Well, hi everybody, and back on again. And this time around, the original plan was to play Puzzle Quest 3 for my second stream, but one, I did test Puzzle Quest 3 earlier, and it did work, which usually means if that game works, most of my other games are also gonna work. So I decided to go ahead and call an audible, and instead stream out Guild Wars 2 instead. Reason being is I gotta work tonight, so it's the start of my two-day work week, which means tomorrow and Saturday I'm usually gonna be pretty well. I'm usually gonna be too enervated from a night at work to really want to do anything really intense. So on those days I'd rather stream something like Gems of War. Since I was off last night, normally I have to work, but I got the night off. I figured now would be a good time to go ahead and stream out Guild Wars 2 instead, while I still can. Because once again, tomorrow and Saturday I'm probably not gonna be up for it. I'm more likely to play something like Gems of War or Puzzle Quest 3, something that's really low impact. So yeah, it's kind of a change of plans, but I'm also assuming that this game isn't gonna crash at any point. If it does, then I'll probably check Puzzle Quest 3. If that crashes too, then I'm gonna have to make a judgment call. So, like usual, I eat and drink when streaming, especially on my second streams. So it's gonna be black beans with teriyaki sauce, and my usual chocolate almond milk. Okay, so I think that should do it. Gotta F5 that. F5 means refresh. I have to refresh a window in order to make it function.
Oh shit. Here we go again.
Oh, and I forgot to mention, the music is gonna be the Black Monolith. It's an hour long, and because I don't really wanna, I don't wanna have to adjust album art, like switch the album art on some of these, I'm picking the one that goes about an hour long. So, cause I'm gonna be too busy playing the game to have to go back and make adjustments. Oh, but it's kind of stuttering. Let me check OBS again. I may not be able to play with this guy, though. My, Mesmer. Yeah, I don't think he can. Sanctum Scramble. Auric Basin. Yeah, I can do maybe one or maybe two of them. Let me check. I don't think he has access to expansion stuff. Nope. Oh, wait a minute. What's this? Nope.
Eat my dust.
Prosperity Waypoint, Vine Bridge, Repair Station. But yeah, I don't think you can access the expansion stuff.
Refreshing.
Yeah, so I think you can only do maybe... maybe the Maguma Jungle one.
I feel strong.
So, I guess what I'll go ahead and do... and then switch to my engineer. I know he can. Seems these guilds I used to be in have died. That's a dead one. That's a dead one. I'll go ahead and rep them. So what I'll probably do then, do the dailies on my engineer, and then switch back over, when they're done, switch back over to my mesmer. And there should have been a vista close by here. Yeah, this one here.
I've been 6 feet tall.
All right, there's one. No, wait a minute. I read that wrong. Maguma Jungle. No, that's not expansion content. Perhaps the Hinterland. Same thing. That one is. So, that was almost a waste of time. Call him back. Okay. And while that's going, let me, I'm gonna pull up my, world boss timers for later. Wait, on second thought, whoa. I wonder if Dragon Bash is still going, which means, Dragon Arena is still going, I don't. Till June 27th. So, yeah, another change of plans. I'm gonna do a Dragon Arena instead. I'm gonna try something else so the game doesn't look like ass. Okay, so there's only three choices there. Yeah, reflections you don't want. Yeah, it's like you only got three choices on here. Yeah, shadows, shaders, I'll keep it low. Okay, I'll switch it to low. What I'm looking for is stuff like this that has several options and not just like two or three. Oh, and in case anyone's curious, I'll go ahead and say this now, just in case the game crashes when I get into it. Randy James, it's actually a flip-flop, I think. His name is James Randy. He's a legendary magician, escape artist, skeptic. He's kind of the, his predecessor is Harry Houdini, and he's he's kind of like a Penn and Teller as well. He goes out and he debunks myths. He calls out like faith healers, scam artists, con artists, etc. I watched a documentary of his some odd time ago, and then as an interesting twist, he's also gay. So I mean, I'm no homophobe, but I find that to be pretty interesting because usually the magicians that I know, I mean, they're all ladies, man. They're all charming, charismatic, and like I said, they're a real hit with the ladies. Not this guy. Yeah, I found that to be pretty interesting. Don't see many like him every day. Oh.
Eat my dust.
Well, yeah, if it gets to be too much, I might have to dial it back down.
Dust. Urge to kill rising.
Urge to kill rising.
Just gonna pick one. Not mounted? I'm assuming you know what you're doing.
Eat my dust!
All right. That's it. Yes, victory!
No, Joe, we're here to mine, not do events. Looks a little better, but it's a little bit laggy though. So I guess I'll have to set him back. Oh, damn. God, that just makes it dark. You know what? I'm gonna pull up Guild Wars Efficiency. So I'm not hopping around all day. Oh, and not in here. Yeah, it ain't in here. I'm looking for a Maguma jungle. It's not in here. To roam around here and hope you get lucky. I do want to do this though, run into this portal. Just to. So the graphics changes will take effect. Yeah, and And believe it or not, this is a heal spec. Trying to remember what it was. Yeah, heal yourself and lose conditions. When healing yourself, nearby.
Kill rising.
Oh shit, I just saw that. That's not a 10-second cooldown. The reason I'm going with Mesmer is, last I played him, I didn't have to push buttons as much. I didn't have to constantly move around as much. Not like on my engineer or elementalist. Lots of mouse and keyboard Olympics with those guys. Supposed to be some notes here. First. Did I mess up? Yeah.
Now we huddle and defend. This isn't a lab, it's a war camp.
Rathi enter. That's it, Krita. Pick up brown area. Oh wait, that's a world boss. Yeah.
Fools, crush the invaders.
Hope I can get there in time. Jump.
Refreshing.
Strong.
Forward, men, to the heart of that fortress.
Not many people. There's hardly anybody here.
Go rising.
Oh.
crushing it.
Okay, so it's any shatter skill. But
nice gear.
Kill rising.
Kill rising.
You know what, I would love to disable that voice. I would love to disable the voice. The problem is, you can't make it character specific. Why my engineer is my main. Most of his attacks don't require tab targeting.
Time to
Okay.
Nice work. Maybe. Stay sharp. You don't know when they'll return. They always come back for more.
Are we? What's the cooldown on this? Yeah, 12 seconds.
My blood honors the earth.
I feel strong.
Looking for the cooldown. 15. Okay, so I guess it wasn't the world boss. So let's go down here where the Mr. Red is. Okay, we're still on Harathi.
We're halfway there, ladies and gentlemen. It only gets tougher from here.
Weakness makes me
refreshing.
I'll hold this one.
Where's the champ? Champ.
Here we go.
That'll do it for the dailies. So, let me find Holbrecht. Holbrecht. I'm just gonna click there. That's not where I wanted to be. There's actually a teleport crystal you can use that'll take you right to the event, but my engineer has it. Can't do that. Cause apparently I can't access Holbrecht.
Eat my dust.
So it seems you have to have actually entered the location first in order to access it from any other portal. Maybe there. Maybe here? Okay. So bust all these. Okay, so I do have it then. And I think I went with the celestial setup mostly because
you're young to be so confident.
Probably because he can do a wide variety of different things. If I was to pick three, it'd probably be condition damage, healing power, and concentration. But I think I chose Celestial instead because it was easier to get. I probably just bought all the gear. Otherwise, I'd have to find the recipes for every single one of them. I'd have to find all the mats. I'd have to craft all the. Then have to use those mats to craft the stuff. It just would have been a greater runaround. Basically, I had more money than time. I'm thinking that's why I went with this. So, none of my interest has been piqued. I'm gonna look that up real quick. Popular place for me. Yeah, I'm gonna look that up. Should be three. Condition damage.
Eat my dust.
I ain't got it. Apothecary, actually. Nope. Try swapping it. I'm not sure if that's gonna do any good. Nope. Let's do healing power.
I heard Scardy is torn between his father and his brother over something.
I know Scardy, but I don't know what it's about.
Eat my dust!
Yeah, there is none. That might have been why I went with Celestial. Like I said, I'm specifically looking for condition damage. Condition damage, healing power, and concentration. I suppose I could probably look it up. Expertise, too. Nope. That don't exist either. Yeah. So let's track condition damage. That's not even in there either. Closest they have is Marshall's. Still trying. Yeah. So, the closest I can get is Harrier's power, healing power, and concentration, but the Mesmer I have there, he's centered around damage over time, so you want either condition damage or expertise.
Dust.
So yeah, I think that's why I went with I think that's why I went with Celestial. The game doesn't have what I'm looking for. Smacking on pinatas. And, once again, the reason originally I was going to be playing on Puzzle Quest 3, but as I have to work tonight, I won't be able to play Guild Wars 2 tomorrow or Saturday because I'm going to be too exhausted from a night of work. I'll want to play something low impact like Gems of War or Puzzle Quest 3. So, and then secondly, this game didn't crash today. It did yesterday, though, so it's just opportunity knocking.
Urge to kill rising!
Oh.
my dust!
So arrogant, so loud. Fills my heart.
Okay, I guess I don't want to jump.
Got any traps for frostworms?
No, but I bet I can make one.
What the hell's that? It ain't my input. Charge.
Thank you. That's what's good.
Now that's a combo.
What did I do? Fingered. Okay, shows are still working.
Strong.
That'd be a good idea if we can get everybody bunched together. Stability is going to come in very handy for this battle. And, I think it's supposed to give everybody all these shatter skills. They're supposed to give everybody all stability as well.
Thank you. Such is how disobedience ends.
Nice using auras here. Auras are combo fields.
Hurts, doesn't it?
Refreshing. Finished. Dust.
I don't think I have any of those manipulations.
Yeah.
dust.
We're up now, I guess.
Eat my dust!
I guess it would help if I hit click the sword column here.
Refreshing.
My dust.
Sharpton.
Liar.
I'm trying to finish this off.
Strong.
All right, this is a new one.
Eat my dust.
Tumorous flesh. Let me see how bad the all. Okay, so it don't look too bad. Yeah, Tumorous Flesh, I forgot the name of the album. Yeah, Tumorous Flesh, Reflecting Spirits. This is a 1991 album, and this is one of the very, very few goth rock albums out there that's not copyrighted. So, at least, not at the time I downloaded this. This is my first time actually listening to it now. Gonna go ahead and break off for a few. I gotta use the bathroom and I'm gonna make me something else to eat while I'm up. I'll be back.
Eat my dust. dust.
I'm not world boss, and I gotta change my Twitch info.
Refreshing.
Oh, don't tell me the taskbar's fucking up. Yep, taskbar shot. So I gotta manually click everything now.
Dust. To kill rising.
Hmm. Whoa!
Eat my dust!
Oh, that's gonna charge up my mattress wall over here.
Refreshing. That feels good.
It's gonna be this one.
That feels good.
Refreshing. Could have sworn I hit that. Oh, we got a holograph engineer or whatever, I don't know what they're called. Oh, this is already the tail end of the run. Holding it on the combo fields.
Refreshing.
Start up another one here in just a second.
Urge to kill rising!
Urge to kill rising!
Eat my dust!
One. No swiftness for Joe.
Maximum pain.
Joe, fat finger to butt, so. Hurry up. I got a pack. So then let me do this. I'm not really targeting anybody. Now I'm still hitting the wrong damn button. What am I shooting at?
Draw.
Oh, we gotta deal with this. Yep. Should give a bunch of people around me stability. It should help them out, because otherwise they're gonna get knocked around a lot. Right into it. No idea what I'm shooting at. Got a mortar.
That's how it's done.
This was spell. kind of necromancer. Only played the necromancer class for like a very brief time. Didn't really care much more. I think it's because they have an ability called Death Shroud, which basically grants them a second health bar. Plus they can do a whole bunch of extra moves. But it's only like a 30, 45 second cooldown, so it's nothing I can really rely on. Where is everybody? Alright, the party's over here. I'm shooting at. I'm facing forward and I target the one directly behind me. I guess I didn't roll out of that. And once again, I'm hitting the wrong one. Thank you. Like I said, I'm still liking this. We got a... I gotta keep us. Gotta pick on. I'll probably have to double check. No, oh, I got hit anyway.
Refreshing.
Oh, that was a waste. Yep. It hits everybody around me. And I think after this, I'm probably gonna switch over to World Boston. I still don't know what that does. Not suited for the game I'm playing. It was all acoustic guitar.
Ruber took the clean 5,000.
When the reactor blew, the world's fabric turned inside out.
So, we still got plenty of time, then.
Eat my dust!
Looks like we got some time to wait. Let me grab my notepad. kind of music? Doom Catacomb or thing? Oh, no. David Ricci, the Occult Summoner. And I guess, since we got a little bit of time, I'll go ahead and adjust the album art on that. So I'm pretty sure. No, it's actually correct. Alright. It's something I've been doing lately. The album art that you see in the upper right corner, a lot of times when I'm adding this stuff to my media player, when it grabs the artwork, it does a real crappy job of it. It like cuts off like the top and the bottom, or it looks real blurry and stuff. So I've had to go on Google Images and grab the artwork directly from there, and then save it to the album.
Eat my dust.
So judging by the blip, 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 somebody's using the bunker down trait. Every time they crit, they lay down a proximity mine.
Eat my dust.
Start.
Refreshing.
Got the bronze for it. See that shockwave until the very last second. I didn't mean to push that.
Oh,
Okay, I guess it wasn't jumping. Heal, please. Right into it. Well, I don't know what else to do. The wrong one again. People are dying all the time. Oh damn, that's on a 32 second cooldown. I need to get there early in case nobody's there. The task bar is shot. And no one here. Let's try out. Technically, it started. But again, no one here. There we go. So, it looks like my task bar has decided it wants to be a piece of shit today. It's like a whole series of song and dance clicks I have to do to be able to get the taskbar to preview the windows for me, so I don't have to manually click on every single one of them to get where I want to go.
Eat my dust.
And no one here either, and I. Dude, are you level one or something? Jesus Christ, are we really that weak?
I've got to get these parts back. So finish up and bring me what you've got.
Oh, he's still at 1%. Yeah, I hope so.
Go right then.
That looks valuable.
What this face says, he needs some to disembowel. I can't shatter my clones. I basically have to keep them in case I'm about to die. Then I'll need to hit F4, which makes me immune to everything for 1 second. Which one I got? People have to come rescue me. What's next? Here, I can find it. Oh, it's up here. Yeah, power break. Yeah, I'm gonna need to be able to cast this fairly consistently, or using one of these shatter skills. Again, I gotta be able to get up. I have to be able to get stability on these guys. There's a. One of these had a... We're supposed to give... stability. Yeah, here it is. Like I said, he has the Great Jungle Worm. I think he has that I can think of right at the moment. Two abilities that's gonna either cause fear, cause you to run away, or he's gonna have another one. You have an easy time rolling away from it or rolling out of it because it's telegraphed. His other one, not so much. We got about 3 minutes. And then my cutoff time is going to be 3 p.m. about 45 minutes from now. Showtime. Bye. I hope I'm not going in the wrong direction. Yeah, apparently I am. I may do it as early as after this boss. I'll show you all how this class works for those that don't know. Whoa, I'm way too close.
Holds no sway over me.
gust ability on him. This one here is telegraphed, though. You can see it coming. It's just gonna deal up everybody.
Unbroken, unshaken. So. I can't move! I can't move!
Now that's a combo!
I'm casting here. No, I didn't get any stability at all.
Refreshing.
Heal, please.
Still.
body.
That feels good.
Buffs on everybody. Just cleanse them right off. Stability on everybody. I'm gonna have to tough it out. Yeah, I'm gonna.
Kill them.
Refreshing. Oh, and I think there is a boss bug with this. It'll heal himself, or it'll feed off the husk even after you've killed them. Yeah.
Refreshing.
So, if this keeps up, there's gonna be a chance to probably end up bailing out of the boss.
Wash the pain away.
good ending. I still feel darkness and death in this place, even with the great worm.
That was a long one. And I was just here, doing one of the dailies. Actually, you know what? Oh, that's why we're at a new album. Gator, the Mountain Keeper. Or the Mountain Keeper, I mean. No, I might actually do a video later on, or at some point in the future about my investment, but for right now, I'll just go ahead and do it here. You get all set up first. I do want to stop here and buy a greatsword.
Eat my dust!
The Legion calls.
The basic nuts and bolts of Mesmer, it centers around clones.
To kill rising.
And there is a difference between phantasms and clones. When you summon a phantasm, it doesn't really do it. They don't really do much, but after a few seconds, they actually become clones that, yeah, this might have been a bad call here. But after a few seconds, these, phantasms will become clones, after which you can use them to shatter, which are these abilities here. Destroy all your clones.
Eat my dust.
But again, when you first summon them, they're just plain Jane phantasms. They haven't taken full physical form. So you have to wait a few seconds. And then another thing too is all these illusions here, you have to have a target form. If you don't have a target, the spell is void. Like how
I won't target anybody. See? A clone doesn't appear at all. You know, again, nobody targeted.
Eat my dust!
Again, you must have an enemy targeted to use that skill. Once again, all your illusions have to be able to target somebody. So, early?
Strong.
I gotta turn that down. And then earlier, when you saw me doing the Dragon Arena runs, when these small, lesser monsters were out, I didn't use these at all. I didn't use any of them. Because monsters ain't gonna stay up long enough for them to really for them to do any damage. So, they'll be dead the moment their target dies. I only use cast of clones on bosses. And then, something else too. If not for this, I probably wouldn't be playing Mesmer. The shatter effect also occurs at your location. So even if you don't have any clones at all, you can still cast shatter and you'll still get some. But if you can see here, the abilities are more effective the more clones you have. This is the effect per clone, including yourself. So, I guess in this example here, distortion, immune to conditions and damage. It says 1 second, but if you have 3 clones with you, and you shit and blow them all, you're gonna have 4 seconds of immunity. I'm hoping you can see the tooltip. Hang on. Yeah, my taskbar is fucking up. There it goes. No, can't tell. Yeah, and then the basic bread and butter jab attack. It bounces between, it bounces twice, basically hitting up to 3 targets. If it hits an enemy, it inflicts the bottom 2, torment, confusion. If it hits an ally, including myself, then it gives me a fury and a might. And, I think, I'll test this out real quick. If there's a choice between, ally or enemy. Then it looks like it alternates between enemy and ally. And the little numbers that you're seeing, are all coming from him. Are all coming from the torment damage and confusion. And but probably no confusion because they're not actually attacking. This ain't gonna matter, because I'm fighting training dummies right now, and they're not gonna attack me. But yeah, whenever you have this up, and if you get hit, you get a random buff, they get a random debuff. Kind of the same thing here. And again, like I said too, these are like I said in one of my other videos, this is also a combo field. It's ethereal. Combo finisher is leap. So and because I didn't target, I don't get the clone. And he has chaos aura, which again means whenever you're hit, then basically this is what kicks in. And then, in case you're curious, the bar that you see down here vulnerable while broken? It's either gonna be light, and it's gonna be blue like this, or it could also be the shield at the left will be red. Oh, this is called a Defiance bar, by the way. Once you've used up this whole blue bar, it turns red, to which you can't do any more disabling type moves on them. It'll start like a light brown, and it'll fill up and up and up. And then it'll turn into blue again, after which you can keep inflicting more disabling stuff. And then some enemies, like bosses, they will be completely immune to all disabling moves. You can't affect them with it at all. You might have seen that. It looks like a brown, looks like a black chain. Kind of like a black chain thingy. Then that means they're completely immune. You can do nothing.
Strong.
Eat my dust.
Alright, so F3 is flashing, it interrupts him. Whoops. Too late. But yeah, I was gonna try to shatter all my clones around him, and you'll see how quick that bar drops. So we'll try it again. Have to wait a few seconds, and you'll know they're up and running. And for some reason, I only got two. F3 is flashing. Technically, that ability would have stunned them for 3 seconds. Or if I had all three clones up and running, it would have dazed them for 4 seconds. And then there's other effects too.
Eat my dust.
And again, confusing nearby foes whenever they take damage whenever they use an ability. I can't switch abilities right now, but this is my main this here, which I hardly ever use. So this is called, these three abilities are called signets. Nearly every class has these. They give you a passive ability. Yeah, they give you a passive ability, but if you activate them, you lose that passive ability for 30 seconds, you know, when it's on cooldown, but you'll get a special one. You know, same thing here. You get swiftness and a random boom every 10 seconds. And then these mantras.
Eat my dust.
They start at zero charges. So you can charge them up, but
unbroken, unshaken.
Have a nice resolve. Wait. But once you do charge it up, oh my freaking god! Bad time for this album to come on. So I guess this one. But yeah, it's one of those albums that I'd rather listen to while playing Gems of War. It's a turn-based game where I can just actually sit back and, like, get off on the music. Or, bad choice of words. I can sit back and get into the music.
one. But once again, mantras. Okay, you got two charges of that.
Refreshing.
You know, in most conditions. You know, same thing here. It can take a long time to charge up. But once you do.
Eat my dust.
So. And then. And then the, and for those who don't know, the way Guild Wars 2 works is, you have,
eat my dust.
You know, you got a whole bunch of, mini talent trees. And, one great thing about, PvP, I gotta... I'll have to go back here. And then, one great thing about PvP is you have access to all the abilities, all the talent, all the mini trees, including the elite ones. The ones that you can only unlock with expansion content and yeah, I don't really want to do it here, but so this is a good place to try different builds out, try out different things. But I'm not gonna do the new stuff here. But what I am gonna do, I probably won't be talking as much.
Urge to kill rising!
Illusionary blade that creates a clone at its wrist. Okay, so this kind of does the same thing too, but it's on an 8-second cooldown. It can bounce up to 4 times though. So it's only given a vulnerability to enemies, but might to everybody else. Probably won't be using that much. Okay. So you can't hard cast any illusions with this one. Or that one you can. That defiance bar just dropped down almost nothing.
Strong.
If I was doing, say, Dragon Arena, I wouldn't really want to use this ability. Unless it's a boss that actually can't be knocked back. Strong. is he only whirls through poles one time. I'm trying to do it all the time, but some confusing wording. So I'm gonna have to run all the way back. That way so I can go out of combat. And then I'm gonna... whichever one had the staff? Yeah. So this isn't really a... it's not a damage over time... time weapon. It's not a damage over time weapon.
Armored up.
Yeah, so it's just... it's raw damage.
Kill Rising.
Yeah, it's a raw damage. Raw damage one. Arrowblade. Oh, 6 bounces. Oh, damn.
Eat my dust.
I could see it. I probably do that one. That's gonna be rare, except maybe in PvP. So...
eat my dust!
Illusions deal increased strike damage to... probably, maybe this one. I'm assuming this means when they're not casting spells and not just merely auto attacking. I mean, otherwise, damn, I think I found my new weapon. But, I tell you what, since I've already changed this bottom one, let me try one of the elite specs. Oh, damn. So... yeah. Oh. Well, let me try dueling first. Let me see. Some illusion will attack your foe. Okay. Not a pistol person. So, yeah, and... percentage.
I'll just go with that. But I guess on the downside, there's nothing really, no combo effects. So.
Eat my dust.
Oh, something else I forgot to mention. Forgot to talk about the middle and upper here. These will probably all stay the same. Yeah.
Eat my dust.
Okay. Shatter skill 2, this one here. Using a torch, so you can use the, this has 2 charges. But, if I'm using a greatsword, because, like I said before, it's just straight damage. It's like no damage over time. I don't need to have that one. So, I'll probably go with that one. Is the healing part, although not really sure I'm gonna need this now. And the only time you want to use medic's feedback is like when you are doing world bosses or any area where there's gonna be a lot of people dying, because this will kick in when you revive anybody. Even like a level 1 shopkeeper. If he's dead, you try to revive him, this will kick in too. So, this ability doesn't differentiate. This here, it actually combos with this, but only once every 10 seconds. So. So, if I was going to go with the greatsword route, I would be using Giver. But I would be using, I'd actually be using what's called Harrier, the Harrier weapon set. It's power, healing power, concentration. Cygnus, yeah, that's gotta stay in there. Staff is mostly for our damage over time.
Eat my dust.
Oh, that's why. Yeah, I'll probably have to do this on my own time. Let's have a celestial greatsword in here somewhere.
Nope.
Yeah, I'll have to make one. So, just gotta start cleaning up and then I'll call it a sesh afterwards.
You can never have too much treasure. That looks valuable. Armored up. Nice gear. Nice gear.
I feel strong. Oh, here we are. All right, so back.
Eat my dust. That looks valuable. My dust.
And then if only to keep the stuff out of my inventory, because my bag is completely full of all of that candy. Just gonna have
refreshing.
To sell it.
my dust.
And these don't stack, so out it goes. Sell them. Don't care to use them, so off they go. Out she goes. Store in the wardrobe.
Eat my dust.
Couldn't I just store it in my wardrobe? Let's go ahead and do that, and then.
Dust. My dust.
Make sure I'm all clean, okay? Alrighty, well, that's gonna do it for me, everybody. I'm gonna go ahead and call it good. I gotta work tonight, so I gotta leave for that here in a few hours. Still need to get going on my blog post, gotta get that written up, and then I need to get this stream video all set up and prepped and exported to YouTube and all that, so still gonna have a fairly busy afternoon and evening. But otherwise, hey, thanks for dropping in and hanging out with me, everybody. I appreciate that, and again, my work week has started up. My two-day work week, so tomorrow and Saturday, I'm usually pretty well ripped and torn up after a night at work. So, on those days, don't be surprised if I don't come on and stream. But if I do, my default time is 2:30 p.m. U.S. Central. And then on those days, probably it's going to be Gems of War. Just something low in impact. It won't be Guild Wars 2, because there's just too much involved, so. And I forgot what I was gonna say. Oh well, but anyway, thanks again for coming by, everybody, and I'll see you all next time. Bye for now.